It's always helpful to know what is abnormal by first understanding what is normal. This is why we're going to look more closely at the normal sinus rhythm ECG first and pay special attention to its findings and measurements. Let's take a look at the rhythm now. Is the rhythm regular or irregular? In this case, it's regular. Next, we look at the rate. What is the rate? This child's rate is 80 beats per minute. And we have to ask ourselves, is that rate normal? Is it fast? Is it too slow? And remember, normal heart rates will vary by age with pediatric patients. A normal heart rate for a 12-year-old might be bradycardic for an infant or newborn. So next, we move on to evaluating the P wave. We ask ourselves, are the P waves present? We can clearly see in this ECG that the P waves are present. Do they occur regularly? And we see that each of the P waves occur regularly. Is there one P wave for each QRS complex? And we see that there is one P wave for each QRS complex. Are the P waves smooth, rounded, and upright? Yes, the P waves are smooth, rounded, and upright. And do all the P waves have similar shapes? And the answer to that is yes. Each of them are uniform in shape, and they're smooth and rounded. So now we want to look at the PR interval for this ECG. Is the PR interval normal, which means it's less than 0.20 seconds? And the answer is yes. Because the PR interval is contained within one large box, which equals 0.2 seconds, the PR interval is normal. Is the PR interval constant? And the answer is yes. So after we answer those questions, we can now move on to the QRS complex of the ECG. Is the QRS interval less than 0.09 seconds? In this case, yes, it is. As long as the QRS fits within two small boxes and is no larger than 2 1/4 small boxes, the QRS is within normal range. Is the QRS wide or narrow? And in this case, the QRS is narrow. Are the QRS complexes similar in appearance? We can see that each one looks similar. So now, what is our cardiac interpretation? Well, based on our findings, we can see that we have a regular rhythm with a normal rate. The P waves look normal, with each P wave being followed up by a QRS rather, and the PR interval is less than 0.20 seconds. The QRS is less than 0.09 seconds, and with these findings, we can interpret the rhythm to be a normal sinus rhythm. So unless the patient has no pulse or other serious signs or symptoms, there is no significance to this cardiac rhythm.